Dear students, let us continue our study in this organic chemistry paper 2. And in this module, we shall be focusing on SCT reactions and will give a special emphasis to the Grignard reactions in this context. Dear students, you shall be able to know about the SCT reaction after going through this module. You will be able to learn how SCT reaction works and identify the key aspects of SCT reaction. You shall be also able to evaluate and understand the mechanism of SCT reaction. You shall be able to analyze some examples of SCT reaction and work out more on your own. The sharing of an electron pair between two atoms or chemical bond has revolutionized the knowledge regarding the molecules, and that you are all already aware. Although chemical reactions involve breaking and remaking of bonds between atoms, chemical conversion always involves shifting of electrons between the atoms. Thus, the mechanism of transfer of electrons which leads to chemical conversions is rather intriguing. Single electron transfer, which is abbreviated as SET. So, these single electron transfer reactions are characterized by electron transfer from a nucleophile to a substrate producing a radical intermediate. And it was in 1966 that Kolmlum and Russell, they proposed the details of SRN1 reactions. And in 1970, it was Bunnett who discovered that such a pathway can be involved in some cases of nucleophilic aromatic sorption, that is single electron transfer reactions. Nature exploits a variety of electron transfer reactions to accomplish very important biological processes, seemingly because these reactions are fast and can take place between well separated moieties. They can be induced by light and can initiate secondary reactions. There are proteins that facilitate electron transfer from one part to another, for example, cytochrome, ferredoxin, rubidoxin, aldehyde oxidase, succinate dehydrogenates, etc. in the living organisms. These proteins contain metal ions which are capable of switching between different oxidation states to transport electron. Activation of substrate by a suitable mechanism often increases its reactivity, and there are many ways to do this depending on the substrate. One way is by proton transfer, as in conversion of an alcohol, which is a poor nucleophilic solvent, into its metal oxide, which in turn is a very strong nucleophile, and this you are already aware. Another example is the acid catalyzed nucleophilic addition to a carbonyl group. So, to understand this in more detail, let us consider the protonation of a carbonyl prior to the nucleophilic attack on the carbonyl carbon. Pre-protonation of the carbonyl oxygen, you are already aware, significantly increases the rate of attack by the nucleophile. Instead of simple resonance partial positive charge on carbon of the unprotonated carbonyl, there is now a much more significant positive charge on the carbon, and thus the reaction rate with the nucleophile is enhanced, as you can see in this equation. So, you can see here that this carbonyl is shown in resonance, where the C gets plus charge, O gets minus, and when the carbonyl as such is attacked by a nucleophile, this attack is slow, giving you this oxyanion followed by protonation. On the other hand, if this carbonyl is attacked by proton, then because of the formation of this carbocation, then this carbon is highly electron deficient and the attack of nucleophile now is very, very fast. Similarly, electron transfer also enhances the reactivity in a very, very analogous manner. Here the charge being transferred is the elementary particle of the negative charge. And as in proton transfer, activation can occur by transfer of an electron either to or from the substrate of interest. A neutral molecule can undergo one electron reduction to give a radical anion or one electron oxidation to give a radical cation. So, these are the two possibilities. Both species are more reactive than the corresponding neutral molecule, and it is very obvious. To consider the potential for SCT in conventional organic reactions, let us consider a simple generic SN2 type reaction as occurring via either a polar or SCT mechanism. The nucleophile, when it attacks on alkyl halide RX in the polar condition, that is going via SN2, then there is formation of NuR and X minus. Now alternatively, if it is proceeding through SCT mechanism, then what is going to happen is that this nucleophile will be transferring the electron to the X, and as a result you can see there is an electron over X giving rise to a minus charge over X, and the nucleophile out of these two electrons only one is left and the Nu is also with dot, that is one electron. So there is a transfer of electron which has happened from the nucleophile to the X or the substrate RX, and then further it will rearrange that it is the Nu dot, R dot and X minus. Now you can see this is facilitating that X minus now goes out and Nu dot and R dot will join and give you this bond formation, and that is the product, that is NuR. So we are familiar that in SN2 reactions the backside nucleophilic attack displaces a leaving group leading to inversion of configuration. However, it is entirely possible that some SN2 reactions, they proceed via SCT from the nucleophile to the alkyl halide giving a nucleophile radical and an alkyl halide radical anion that would then rapidly dissociate into an alkyl radical and a halide ion as we have seen now. If these processes as well as the subsequent nucleophile radical alkyl radical coupling, they occurred in cage as a geminate cage pair, then inversion of configuration and all other conventional SN2 criteria would be met. SCT has emerged as an attractive and an exciting process in organic chemistry over the past few decades. And if we go into the various steps, SCT reactions involve 4 steps. The first step is the electron transfer from the nucleophile to the substrate, that is RX. The second step is the radical anion dissociates into radical, that is R dot, which in turn then reacts with nucleophile. The third step is to form the product radical anion, and the fourth step is that there is a generation of RNU as the product and the radical chain process is continued, this being a radical mechanism. So all these 4 steps you can see are clearly shown here. SCT leads to free radicals, radical anions and radical cations. The intermediates are paramagnetic, and therefore detection of these species during a reaction by ESR technology will be a proof of SC2 process operating in such reaction. In so far as organic chemistry is concerned, electron transfer reactions have been exploited to a great extent for unraveling mechanistic insights. The electron transfer has been widely applied for the synthesis of organic probes and biologically active natural products. So, let us now move into more details of the SCT reaction and consider the types of electron transfer reactions. Electron transfer reaction can be divided into two types. They are, first, the photo-induced electron transfer reactions, and these are abbreviated as PET reactions. The second is chemically induced electron transfer reactions, and these are abbreviated as CET reactions. So, let us go into more details of the PET reactions, that is photo-induced electron transfer reactions. When light is exploited to induce transfer of an electron from a donor, as represented here by D, to an acceptor, as represented here by A molecule, the reaction is designated as photo-induced electron transfer or PET. PET reactions can be further subdivided into two classes or subclasses. And these two subclasses are the radical acceptor reactions and the radical ion reactions. So, let us go into more details of these one by one. Let us begin with donor acceptor reactions. And here, as the name suggests, that obviously there is a donor acceptor relationship, and they have been further classified with respect to the chemistry of different categories of organic compounds. To begin with, let us consider the photochemistry of arenes. A large part of photochemical electron transfer initiated donor acceptor reactions have been focused on aromatic compounds. In 1980s, Arnold et al. Investigated the photoaddition of electron rich olefins, which will be acting as donors, to the electron poor cyanoaromatic compounds, which will be acting as acceptors in the polar solvents. And for example, you can consider this equation where this aromatic ring joined with two cyano at the para position is acting as acceptor, and when this is reacted in the presence of photolytic conditions with this alkene, then this alkene being electron rich will be acting as donor, and as a result there is a combination of these two molecules giving rise to these two products, this one in 10% yield and this much in 18% yield. Moving to the other case, which is the chemistry of carbonyls. Carbonyl compounds behave as electron acceptors in PET reactions, and they form anion radicals upon electron transfer from the electron donating partners. For example, if we consider the photoreduction of carbonyls, carbonyl compounds undergo photoreduction to the corresponding alcohols when reacted with amines. The process is initiated by electron transfer from the amine to the carbonyl in its excited state, generating an ion pair. So, let us see what are the steps involved here. The first step, as you can see here, is the formation of ion pair. So, suppose we start with this ketone, and in the presence of photolytic conditions and this triethylamine, there is formation of, you can see, the anion radical on the carbonyl and the cation radical on the amine. And further, it goes into formation of free radical at the carbon with O minus, and here the solvent separated ion pair is thus formed. The step 2 are the subsequent reactions, that is, you can see here that this particular triethyl amine as cation radical will be undergoing elimination of H dot and giving you this alkene with nitrogen bearing a positive charge. And this carbon free radical in this ketone, where O is minus, that is you are having this as the radical anion. This can go into dimerization, giving this particular dimer type of molecule, where O minus, and further it can lead to pinnacle type of formation, or this can take the H dot and followed by protonation will be giving you this alcohol, which will be the reduced product. If you look at the fate of the nitrogen cation which has formed, this further when it is worked up with water will be adding OH at the carbon or through the double bond, and furthermore it will split to give you diethylamine and acetaldehyde. Let us now consider the photocyclization of delta epsilon unsaturated ketones. The photoreductive cyclization of delta epsilon unsaturated ketones in the presence of hexamethyl phosphoric triamide is as shown here. So you can see here that in the presence of photolytic conditions, there will be combination of this carbonyl with this alkene, and as a result there is the formation of these two products. This one is formed in 45% yield and this much is formed in 30% yield, and it is the difference between these two is the attack, whether it is giving you the OH and this methyl substituent on the same side or on the other side. Moving to the next one is the photochemistry of ketone olefins. The regioselective formation of the product can be rationalized on the basis of a photochemically induced umpulung of 2,3-butadiene and direct coupling of the radical ion pairs subsequently. And this you can see in this particular equation, that this dicarbonyl when it reacts with this ester in the presence of photolytic conditions and benzene as solvent, there is formation of this product by the coupling of these two. Moving next is the photochemistry of organic halides. The electron transfer between the radical species generated from CX homolysis is the best example for this. And as you can see here, the RX, that is alkyl halide, when it is subjected to photolytic condition, there will be formation of RX as ion pair through ACT reaction, and then it will be giving rise to the product. So now considering the photochemistry of organic halides as another example, the electron transfer between the radical species generated from CX homolysis is the best example here. And as you can see in this equation, RX in the photolytic condition via the ACT reaction, it will first form the ion pair, which is R plus and X minus, and eventually there will be again electron transfer and formation of product, that is R dot and X dot. Now after this, let us move to the next subcategory, that is the radical ion reactions. The most important outcome of photo induced electron transfer is the generation of radical ions, that is radical cations and radical anions, and subsequent reactions arising from them. So let us consider them one by one. Let us begin with chemistry of radical cations. And under this, let us consider the case of mesolytic reaction, that is carbon hydrogen bond dissociation reactions. Formation of radical cation from a neutral molecule is generally accompanied by increase in the acidity of the substrate. The photosensitized electron transfer from excited starting material in the presence of DCN as an electron acceptor in wet acetonitrile generates the arene radical cation, as you can see here, which further undergoes efficient deprotonation to the benzyl cation, and this subsequently on hydrolysis leads to the debenzylated product, that is the benzyl group has been removed from this one. Next we move to the chemistry of radical anions. generation of a radical anion by photo-induced electron transfer from a donor or sensitizer species to an electron acceptor moiety happens. For example, let us first consider the bond cleavage reactions. The organocelium radical anions generated via photosystem comprised of 1,5-dimethoxynephrine as a light harvesting electron donor and ascorbic acid as a sacrificial electron donor may undergo heterolytic bond cleavage to yield phenyl selenium, selenium phenyl, as you can see in this equation. Let us try to understand the mechanism of this, and as you can see here, the HA minus is the ascorbate ion, A is representing the dehydroascorbic acid, and DMN is 1,5-dimethoxynephthalene. And you can see here that how this via the SET, that is the electron transfer reaction, there is the formation of this carbon free radical along with Sc minus pH, and this further will be dimerizing to give the product, which is pH Sc Sc pH. And if we look at the fate of this ascorbate part, then there will be formation of ascorbic acid along with dehydroascorbic acid and the release of proton. And in between you can see this DMN, that is 1,5-dimethoxynephthalene, will be forming the DMN plus, because it will be losing the electron and giving it to the selenium compound and in turn going out as DMNS. So that's how the electron transfer is being facilitated and you are having the formation of product. The next case is the electrophilic addition reactions. In general, arene radical anions of polynuclear aromatic hydrocarbons such as phenanthrene photogenerated via electron transfer from amines as the electron donor have been shown to undergo carboxylation reaction by the electrophilic addition of carbon dioxide, and this is then followed by termination of the resultant species by hydrogen abstraction from the solvent. And this you can see from this particular reaction that this is how it will be the formation of this product, where the carbonylation has occurred, where carboxylation reaction has taken place. Next we move to is the, after studying PET, let us move to CET, that is chemically induced electron transfer reactions. Addition or removal of an electron to or from a neutral molecule can also be achieved by chemical means and not only the photo-induced mean that we have studied till now. The reactions usually carried out under photochemical electron transfer process can in principle be accomplished chemically, if we want to say in other words. The subdiscipline that deals with reactive intermediates generated using certain compounds has come to be known as chemically induced electron transfer abbreviation, which is used. The best example for the CET reaction is the Diels-Alder reaction by using ammoniamyl salt, which is referred to as the whole catalyst, and it results in the formation of 4+2 and 2+2 cycloaddition products, as you can see here. So you can see in this equation that how the Diels-Alder reaction of this butadiene and ethene in the presence of the whole catalyst is first of all giving you these intermediates, where the diene is forming the cation radical and ethene is forming the anion radical via the electron transfer. And subsequently you can see these are the products. The first one you can see, they are giving you this cyclohexene and this four membered product, or alternatively this product, the second one, is getting formed by combination of ethene plus ethene as cyclobutane, and these products you can see they are being formed by combination of butadiene with butadiene. So you have all these possible 4 plus 2 and 2 plus 2 cycloaddition products which are getting formed. Another such example you can notice is that this is another diene where there is these two cyclopentyl rings are joined in this diene system, and then it is being reacted with this alkene where X most preferably is the electron withdrawing group. And in the presence of this particular catalyst, which is the ammonium ion salt as whole catalyst, what we get are the formation of this 4 plus 2 addition product, as well as you can see we are getting this particular 2 plus 2 addition product. Now, after studying about the SET reaction and the further classification as PET and CET, let us now take a special reference or special note on Grignard reactions. Grignard reaction, you know, is the addition of an organomagnesium halide, which is the Grignard reagent, to a carbonyl compound to give an alcohol. The reaction with formaldehyde, you all are already aware, leads to a primary alcohol, while other aldehydes they give secondary alcohols. And if we start with a ketone, then you will be getting a tertiary alcohol. The reaction is of very wide scope, and a generalized pathway for the Grignard reaction is as shown here. That is, you are having the carbonyl compound which is aldehyde or ketone, when reacted with this RMGX represented here by R dash MGX to differentiate between the alkyl of ketone and Grignard. Then we have the formation of this intermediate where R dash has attacked on the carbonyl carbon as nucleophile, and in turn O minus has joined with the MGX positive. And this subsequently on hydrolysis gives you the corresponding alcohol, that is this OMGX goes into hydrolysis, we get OH. So this mechanism you are already aware. Now let us try to see it through the SET mechanism part. There is evidence that some Grignard reactions may proceed via SET mechanism, or we can say at least a part of the reaction, if not the entire reaction, proceeds via this mechanism. And such a process, if we try to see, is shown as you can see that RMGX when reacted with aldehyde or ketone, and in the presence of SET, that is the electron transfer mechanism, what happens is the formation of this anion radical from the carbonyl compound and the cation radical from the Grignard will be taking place. So you can say electron has transferred from the Grignard to the carbonyl compound. Furthermore, what happens is there will be formation of R dot part from the Grignard cation radical, and the remaining MgX plus will be joining with O minus. So this carbonyl part is giving rise to this radical, which is radical at carbon. And now obviously in the presence of solvent cage, this R dot and C dot will be joining, and that is how there is a formation of this particular product. So I repeat here, that is the R dot from the Grignard, that is R dash dot, and that is joining to the C dot and giving rise to this particular product. A significant observation is that SET process is favored by small amounts of transition metals. That is, metal impurities are always found in magnesium metal, you should remember this. And these trace metals promote the electron transfer reactions. Another noteworthy observation is the absence of 1,2-diol products arising from the dimerization of the magnesium ketyl. This means the metal ketyl is not free and the reaction is occurring in the solvent cage. Grignard reagent is perhaps the best example of SET, and having other types of Grignard reactions, they also may follow SCT mechanism. So, dear students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. In this module, you have become familiar about the single electron transfer reactions, that is SCT reactions. We have studied about how the mechanism of these SCT reactions takes place, and we have seen that there are proteins and enzymes which contain metal ions, which are capable of switching between different oxidation states to transfer electron. And it is because of these that the SCT reactions come into play. Electron transfer reactions, they also enhance the reactivity. And we have seen how they are further classified as photoinduced electron transfer reactions, or they are also categorized as chemically induced transfer reaction, that is CET reactions. And correspondingly, we can say that CET reactions can be induced by either photolysis or by chemicals. And we have considered many examples to understand both the PET and CET reactions. SCT mechanism is another pathway in the study of reaction mechanism. And always keep in mind that it's not that whatever conventional mechanisms you have studied, they are not operating. So, it's actually a blend of both of these. Some molecules take those pathways and some take place via the SCT. And in the particular case of Grignard reactions, we have seen that how when Grignard reagents attack on carbonyl compounds giving you formation of alcohols, then some molecules can proceed via the SCT reactions, and there are evidence in favor of this.